Good morning, tradeologists. Well, today, Avon Products, our Gamma Scalping trade stock, is up sharply this morning. We're short 290 shares. That gives us a long delta of 137. We're still short 290 shares. In order to get delta neutral here this morning, we need to sell another 130 shares or so. I'm going to be slightly... Now, you can... There's a couple different ways you can look at this. Is your long deltas, and if you want to, you could play it a little bit to the short side. So you could say, well, you know, if you think it's going to go down, you could do, instead of selling 100 and, well, it's moving quickly actually now, if you sold another 150 shares and you wanted to be slightly short delta, you could actually sell a little bit more than that. You could sell 170 shares. Or if you wanted to be slightly long delta, if you thought that the stock was going to continue to move up, then you'd only sell maybe 110 or 120 shares. So that gives you a slightly long or short delta. Let's take a quick look at the chart here on AVP. First, we'll take a look at a longer-term two-year chart. It looks like we're in this trading range here, and it's kind of bumping up against the top end of that range. So, you know, once we get up to wherever this line is here, actually we could probably move this down just a little bit to there. Looks like it's kind of breaking through there, so we may want to have a long position. We could sell some short here just in case it does retrace, or we can kind of hold on and wait and see what happens. The best choice is probably to keep an eye on, if you have a little bit of technical analysis, you could probably do a little bit better by trying to time your trades. Now, we've got the ultimate high up here on a 20-day, 30-minute chart. The stock has moved up quite high here, so let's just go back here to the... where's my chart? There it is. We want to do a price level right in there, which was the old high where before it started selling off again. So once we get to that point, we don't want to wait too long to adjust our deltas because we may miss an opportunity here. At this point, we are long 165 deltas. I'm going to try to round out the number of shares that we have because we're currently short 290 shares. If I sell 110 shares here, that'll kind of round out our number. So I'm going to go ahead and send that in. And we sold short 110 shares. That gets us almost a delta neutral. We're a little bit long delta, 50 shares long, just in case it continues to move back up a little bit. So if it continues to move back up a little bit, you know, we'll have those long deltas working in our favor. And if it decides to sell off at this point, we're 400 shares short. So either way, we're okay. As long as if this continues to move up, the idea is to continue to bring it back into a delta neutral position so that we are, you know, so we're able to take advantage of the price fluctuations as the stock moves around. Right now, we're short at, what did we get short? We got short at 37 and just a fraction of a cent. So that is right in there we're short. We can put a little note in there. Short at 37. 110 shares. So now we are... now we're short about 400 shares. All we have to do is keep an eye on our deltas. As it continues to move up, we can sell some more short, or we can let the deltas ride if we think that there's a good opportunity here for the market to continue higher. And that's pretty much all we have to do. Remember that, you know, our full stock position would be about 400. We're 400 now. Our full stock position would be at 1,000. Once we get to 1,000 shares with a delta neutral position, then there's pretty much nothing else that we can do after that point. We can't make any more money, but we can't lose any either. One of our call positions or our put position is going to be deep into money, And at that point, there's not much we can do. If the stock sells off, we'll be short 1,000 shares, and we'll make quite a bit of money on a sell-off. But at this point, we just kind of keep an eye on our delta. We want to be a little bit long delta maybe in case we get a pretty good rally here. We'll make some additional money on the long side because of our long call. Otherwise, we'll just kind of keep an eye on it, and we'll try to find some other opportunities in which to do some gamma scalping on other issues. I changed the gamma worksheet just a little bit. As I find new stocks, I kind of bring those down and kind of add them to the list here as I go along. I've added a column here for days to expiration, which you can add into your spreadsheet if you like. I've also added a little a column here for intraday moves. In other words, what's the expected move for the stock intraday? And the way we did that, if you recall, is that we went into our Analyze tab, we went over to Probability Analysis, and we took the range of the probability of touching with the current ranges, and right now for AVP, it does change on a daily basis. It's 42.58 minus 32.22, that's 1036 divided by the number of days left in this expiration cycle, which is 18, and that gives us a 57.5 cent move a day. So we're still close to 58 cents. So that's all you have to do to determine kind of like when you should probably begin adjusting deltas is right around a 58 cent move in the stock. So let's go back here to our main window, and we'll take a look at our risk profile. We're long 99 deltas. Once we get to a couple hundred deltas, I want to probably go short again, but you know, as long as it stays around 100 deltas, we could sell another 100 shares short here, but I want to keep an eye on the chart, because if we can kind of determine where the high is going to be, then we can actually, you know, when a stock moves up this sharply, the chances are for falling just as sharply, so we want to be able to capture those opportunities if we can here. This is a 5-minute chart. We can go to a 15-minute chart to give us a better feel for the stock itself. And we can see how this looks like it's gone past this here. We don't want to miss any opportunities in the stock. It has run up extremely sharp here. It looks like we have earnings announcements maybe coming out for the stock. Let's take a look and see if there's any earning alerts for the company. AVP, no, I don't see it. Let's see. Let's go down a little bit farther here. It looks like they got something coming out, though. So we want to keep an eye on that. I mean, it doesn't matter to us, actually. Large movement is good. But if it's too large, then we want to make sure that we're either long or short deltas. Yeah, here it is. Avon Products comes out July 30th before the market. And that's tomorrow. Okay, so we've got some earnings announcements coming out for Avon Products. And so they continue to roll up a little bit here. This might be some pre-market buying if people are expecting the earnings to be good. We may want to be a little bit long delta here. I mean, we're already short 400 shares. So, you know, with earnings coming out tomorrow before the market, which means today is the last trading day before the earnings announcement of tomorrow morning. So, you know, let's keep an eye on this. You know, I don't mind being a little short stock and a little bit long delta, just in case we do get a good punch and pop up on the stock. So that's the way I'm going to play it today. And if I do any more adjustments, I will definitely let you know, as usual. So stay tuned, and we'll see what we have on the rest of the trading day. And in addition, I'm going to be looking for some additional gamma scalping candidates here by filling in our spreadsheets, you know.